Okay, welcome everybody to Research 3 2017. Thank you all for coming. I've got a few introductory remarks to make, and then I'm going to introduce our keynote speaker. So let's see what we've got here. So I better introduce myself first. So my name is Mark Carden. I'm the director of the conference, and you'll be hearing from me interminably throughout the event as I introduce people and so forth. This is not my real job, so I'm actually a recruitment consultant. So I mostly do headhunting with a firm called Mosaic. And in my spare time, I just sort of throw together this conference. It's pretty straightforward, really. So that's my proper job. Mosaic's also a sponsor of the conference. In the pack, you'll find an amusing document about Mosaic that you can read at your leisure. Moving on, I think first of all, what I ought to do is to just do a lot of thank yous. So I've got a lot of people to thank, but this won't be as interminable as you fear. The first people to thank is you, the delegates, for coming here. Turnout's about the same as it was last year, which is great. Tell all your friends and we can grow it a little bit. I don't want to get too big, but we could easily handle 20 or 30 more people. So thank you very much for coming. I'd like to thank our speakers and who've contributed a lot of preparation time to this, but also loads of other people. So we have panel chairs, we have panelists, we have workshop organisers. So there's a load of people who've really helped make this work. And it's the advisory board that's really helped me to gather together such a top-flight group of people and topics to present to you today and tomorrow. So thank you to all of those. I'd like to thank the events team, that's the folks from the events hub. Last year I kind of organised it all myself, which was terrifying. I decided to get some professional help, and they've been great in helping me to do that. Also, sponsors, of course. Without the sponsors we couldn't do this. Ticket prices would be double what they are without our sponsors, so I do want to thank them. I want to say a word or two about delegates. Somebody told me in a public speaking tip that the first thing you should always do is talk about your audience, because that makes them happy. So I just thought I'd take a minute or two to talk about you. So who are you? Well, first of all, what sector are you from? So this is, broadly speaking, where you're from. Mostly publishing, but a good group of librarians and research people and technology people as well. So it's a really nice kind of group, and I think one of the nice things about this conference is it brings together publishers with academics and scholarly publishing experts and all kinds of people. So that's a nice group. If you compare that with last year, it's quite similar, broadly the same statistics, so it's the same mix. We've tried hard to encourage more librarians and academics to come. I've reduced the prices to loss-making levels to encourage them to come, and I hope to continue to grow that group. Where are you from? I thought you might be interested to see that. So, strongly dominated by the UK still, inevitably not surprising because of the location, but a good sprinkling of people from other countries, notably the USA. Happy President's Day to the Americans here today. That's not... anyway. Last year, kind of a similar mix. I'm pleased to say the kind of UK percentage is dropping, not that I don't want people from the UK, but it's nice to have an international balance of the people here. What else can I say about you? Gender balance. Here's the gender balance this year. Pretty much 50-50, 1% other. I don't know whether that's a sort of gender neutrality warrior or somebody who just clicked the wrong box, but anyway. Quite similar to last year, so... you know, a nice balance there. There is a more sophisticated balance to consider. So Learned Publishing published quite an interesting article about different conferences and their speaker gender distribution. They didn't include us for some inexplicable reason, but presumably they will next time. And actually, we did pretty well last year on that, and we're doing fairly well this year. If you look at this year for us, speakers is disastrous, to be honest. I don't quite know what happened there. But our workshop organisers and panellists and delegates balance is great. But I think we need to do something about speakers. The previous year, actually, our speaker balance was a bit better, but our panellists balance was quite poor. So it's a bit of a moving feast according to who you get and what you want to do, but we are sort of conscious of that gender balance as well. Regulars and newbies, I'm sorry about that, newbies is not really polite, is it? But, so who are returning delegates and who are new delegates? Again, a nice mix. So returning delegates here is an estimate, actually, of anyone who's ever been to an ASA or R2R conference before. there. That was last year. So we're getting a good proportion of people who like to come back year after year for some reason. So great. Thank you very much for that. The other slightly more sophisticated comparison is probably this one, which is actually comparing specifically last year and this year. So 39% of you are returners from last year. So you can look forward to my summary at the end of the conference and be exceptionally bored by hearing that again. So looking forward to that. Okay. Just so to reiterate, I just wanted to extra thank the speakers, panelists, workshop organisers, because without them, this simply couldn't happen. So I just thought I'd slap their faces up there so you know who they are. Obviously, you can see them all in their biographies in the programme, and I'll be introducing them as they come up to speak. And I've also mentioned our our advisory board. So here they are, and you can see them on the website, and here are their pictures. I'm pleased to introduce Anthony Watkinson, who's just joined the advisory board. He has done a particularly good service, the advisory board, by breaching the second half of the alphabet. And we do have a demographic problem with the advisory board. If you're interested in joining the advisory board for next year, please do get in touch. And the demographic that we're particularly looking for, we're particularly interested in librarians, we're particularly interested in women, because we're a bit low for women on there, but most importantly, people whose surnames are in the second half of the alphabet. Okay, so moving on, we just really must mention the sponsors thoroughly. So we have two silver sponsors, there are only two, and it's Aspen Digital Science there. We have a vacancy for a gold sponsor for next year, Mark. And we also then have a bunch of bronze sponsors who I'd also like to thank. They've made a huge contribution financially to keeping ticket prices down and making the whole thing viable. And also we have some sponsors who particularly sponsored meal breaks and things like that. So thank you to them. And you'll hear me mentioning them all as we progress through the conference again and again. Okay, force me to do the housekeeping. So the emergency exits are here. Anyway, if there's a fire, leave the building. So I do have a few things to go through. So the Wi-Fi password, Wi-Fi is being sponsored by Ringgold again. I'd like to thank them for that. Ringgold were our first ever sponsor, and so they deserve special mention. The password, extraordinarily, it's the Wi-Fi's visitor, and the password is winter spring 2017 with a capital W and the space, don't forget. If you have any problems with the Wi-Fi, don't tell me, tell the events team. I just tried to log on and couldn't, so yeah, we'll see how we go with that. Twitter, if you're going to tweet, please tweet. The hashtag is R2RConf, so please do tweet throughout the conference. It's useful for people who are not here to see how great it is, but also to kind of communicate within the group, and I'll be trying to follow a bit of the Twitter to see interesting questions and comments that come up. Timekeeping is crucial, so we must absolutely stick to time. I'm looking at my timing list here. We've already started a little bit late, but we'll crack on and try and keep the time. Particularly, I would say, coming out of workshops, please do try and come out of your workshops on time. We've had a lot of support and help, and I particularly like to mention the events team, who've been enormously helpful. They are possibly in the room standing at the back. Can I ask you to just come forward and be visible? The events team have red flashes on their badge instead of blue. So, as I always say at this point, if you're concerned the room is too hot or too cold, it's certainly quite warm at the moment. I had a super thick tweed suit. It's my super thick tweed suit. But I've already abandoned the jacket because it's so hot. But if you have any concerns about temperature, Wi-Fi, all those kind of things, do not tell me about it. I'm really not interested. Tell the events team here with their red badges, and they will do everything they can to help you with any concerns that you have at all. So I'd like to thank them for their tremendous support. Thank you. Okay, moving on. Conduct. Everyone behave themselves, please. Name badges and security passes. Your name badge contains a security pass in it. You'll need that to get in and out of the building. Please hold on to that for tomorrow as well. And then please return all the badges and security passes at the end when you finally leave. The other thing on name badges, you'll see there's a micro program on the back. So if you're wandering around lost and you don't know what's next, there is a program on the back. Participant survey, this is the most important part of the whole conference. In your bag, you should have a delegate survey. It's half as long as it was last year, which means there should be twice as many people filling it in. please, please fill that in properly as you go, and don't forget to hand it out before you leave. Video recording, we're recording the events, the speakers. We're also doing a bit of light video recording and photography and workshops and things like that, but nothing too onerous. We're not doing the Vox Pop videos that we did last year because people hated them, but we will be trying to do some audio interviews during the breaks just to hear what people have to say about the conference. Map, there is a map on the back of your program so you can find your way around, but it is a bit of a labyrinth. Do ask the events team if you get lost. Fire exits. Where they say fire exits. There is, delightfully, as always, a fire alarm test at 11 o'clock. So you'll be in your workshops, so that will wake you up in your workshop, but do not leave the building unless the fire alarm continues for a very long time. Otherwise, it's just a test. Okay, I think that is pretty much it. I'm just going to say one thing about what this conference is about for the people who are new or here by mistake. I once went to the wrong conference by mistake, which was actually particularly interesting, but it can happen. I think what this conference is about is really about this whole supply chain from the researcher to the reader. It's about the interactions between all these elements that deliver the content and how they connect to each other. It's not about the silos and the individual spaces of publishing or peer review or authoring. It's about those connections and connectivity. And I think we have a really good conversation here where the conversation isn't within one little space, but it's about how it all fits together. So that's really what we're trying to do here. Okay. The program, I'm not really going to say anything about that. You've got a program with you. You can see what's happening on the timetable there. The only thing I would say is at the end of the conference, after the end of the conference, I would mention Scholarly Social, which is academic publishing trip down the pub. This is where it is. If you have any questions about where it is or when it is or anything, ask the events team or Bernie Folan, who's sitting here at the front. And that makes a nice finish to the event.